I'm Lindsay. I'm Lindsay Deutsch. I play the violin and I play with Take 3, which is my band. I like to sound cool. They're really just a string trio with piano, but it's my band. And I grew up as a classical violinist. When I was 2 years old, I was watching a show called Sesame Street. It's still around all these years later. And I saw a very famous violinist named Itzhak Perlman, and he's now old, but he's the most famous violinist in all the land. And the sad thing about him is he cannot walk. He had polio as a child, so he's actually just unable to walk, but hey, it didn't affect his finger movement, so that's a good thing. So anyway, I was watching Sesame Street, and Itzhak Perlman came on, and he played the violin, and I just knew. I have felt it so strongly in my bones, I said, that's it, that's what I wanna do. And my parents then proceeded to not give me a violin for 3 years. After 3 years of begging, you do the math, it's almost 1,000 days. I begged for a violin, they gave me a Kleenex box, okay? So I got a Kleenex box and it was strung with rubber bands, and that's why now I'm a world-class pizzicatoer. But I practiced every day on that from 2 years old to 5 years old. And then when I became 5 years old, I got my very first $10 wooden violin and a bow. And that's how I learned to play. And I loved it. So I'm so happy to do this concert for you. You're gonna learn about the violin. We're gonna do some Name That Tune. You're gonna see some videos. It's gonna be great. Stay tuned. All right, here's how this is going down. This is really fun to do live, but even more fun to do by yourself at home. We're gonna do some Name That Tune. So I'm gonna play the tune. I hope I remember the tunes. And then you don't even need to raise your hand at this point. Just scream it out as loud as you can. And then after I play, I will tell you what it was. Hopefully you're right. There are no prizes here, but write in. If you got them all right, I'll try to send you a Starburst or something like that. All right, here's the first one. My favorite video game, to give you a hint that you do not deserve, probably. This is one from my day, from many decades ago, but I think you guys are still playing this. Tell me. Here's another one. over the rainbow. I realize that's a little old school too. I need to hire a child to tell me what is in right now. One of you can help. Okay, here's the last one. Give you something sugary to rot your teeth out immediately. Hope you won this game. Okay, it's been a very long quarantine. We've all been at home. We've been a little lonesome. We haven't had play dates like we like to. And I haven't been able to play music with my friends. So I realized I can actually play music with my friends using an in-ear piece. I funnel their sound into my ear and I play. So basically all through this quarantine, I've been at home playing with friends from all over the country. First is a video called Smile. I did it with a pianist on the East Coast, Thomas Pandolfi. We toured together. So I hope you like this first one. Of all time. It's called Imagine. It was written by John Lennon. Beautiful words. So for this, I used one of my favorite pianists in Los Angeles and one of my favorite cellists from New York. One of the hardest videos ever to put together because we were all listening in our ears and I had to put it together and I'm not a professional videographer at all. So this was actually harder afterwards to put all together than it was to video. Here is Imagine.
It's easy if you try. Nowhere below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for play.
when I ran out of friends to record with, I decided, you know what? Karaoke track. So then I recorded this one, What a Wonderful World, to a track. Again, in my ear. Hope you enjoy. Okay, so have you heard of a mashup? You mash up two songs at once. It's very fun. I really enjoy it. So this next one is Natural by Imagine Dragons, and that's mashed up with a very classical opera from Carmen. And it goes like this. Listen for this.
Thank you.
to be the coolest instrument of the orchestra. I chose it because it's the coolest instrument of all the instruments. And I want to tell you about this one in particular and then what all this is, because there's a lot of piece parts that go into this. I did not make it myself. So this violin I found in New York, and it was made in 1845, so a couple hundred years ago. And this is not something that you would use for firewood if you ran out on a camping trip. It's very valuable. It's worth more than most homes. So I'm still paying it off day by day, little by little, just chomping away at that. And the amazing thing is that even with technology, this instrument that was made 200 years ago is better than modern instruments. It gets better with age, like fine wine. Okay, so the parts of this. This is how we tune. These are the pegs. There's four of them with the four strings. Then we have the scroll. It looks like a head. The strings. The fingerboard, where we put our fingers. Very important, the bridge. It holds everything together. Believe me, if the bridge goes, everything goes. Sounds like a gunshot. That should not happen. F holes, that's where the sound projects out of. The bout. You can see it's pretty chewed up. I play very harsh. I've chewed up some of the bout. It will be fixed. End pin. Tailpiece. Tuner. Here we have to have a chin rest to put our chin on. Shoulder rest, as you can see. 20 years of age. I need to get new equipment, but I love this shoulder rest, so that's the thing. And that's how the violin works. All right, so you're probably at this point asking, music, is that a career? How do you make money? Are you poor? Here are the answers to all of your questions. All right, so I tour around the world. I tour in a band with Yanni. You probably do not know him because he's kind of very old school, from like 30 years ago. Your parents probably know him. And so I tour around the world with him. And then I tour with my group, Take Three. And we tour all around the country. We have about 50 shows a year. We drive and drive all around. We bring all of our gear and a day in the life on tour with Take Three. What's it like? Here you go. We wake up at the crack of dawn. And then we drive 4 to 5 hours to our location. We get there. We do sound check. We put on all of our gear. We have all kinds of stuff. We have belt packs, in-ear monitors, microphones. We have to set all of that up. It takes about an hour, hour and a half. Then we have sound check because every venue is different. Every day is different. Then we play for about an hour, make sure all of our gear is working properly. Then we have a lighting check. I teach them what kind of lighting to do and when. And I have already sent them our lighting plot, but I teach them again. And then my favorite time, the best time of my day, dinner time. What will it be? Did they give us good options? Is it a buffet? And you know, usually it's very delicious, usually with a dessert involved. Then I have to get dressed, get my face to look like this. Lots of makeup and dress in my fancy costumes, very shiny, very cool. And then the easiest part of the day is the 2-hour show, which I love and I have so much fun and I just get to be myself. And I tell jokes on stage as well. It's very funny. Comedy night. But that's kind of the day in the life. Very great. And I get paid to play music most of the time. When I was your age, people told me music is very hard. Think twice. You may not want to choose this as your career. And they said, if you do not practice hard hours and hours every day, you will never achieve your goals. So every day I would wake up and I would practice, and I would strive, and I would strive to be better, and I just wanted to be as good as I could be. And I never knew if I was good enough, but I never gave up. And people would say, oh, but there's so many violinists that are better than you, and we can't hire you on our series because there are some violinists that are better than you. I said, if they're better than me now, they will not be better than me next year. And I continued, and I struggled, and I strived to be the best me. And after 20 years of fighting, I'm still here. It's still a struggle every day, but I will never give up. I love what I do. I'm passionate, and I will strive to be better every day and keep going. And you have to do the same. whatever you find, basketball, football, architecture, whatever it is, do it to the best of your abilities with all of your heart. Never give up and keep going. You guys have been the best audience I have ever heard. You could hear a pin drop in here. You've been so attentive, so quiet, so amazing. Thank you for being with me. I want to see you in person very soon, and I know that's gonna happen. Stay safe, wear your mask, enjoy, and you can follow me on social media. I'm Take3 Trio on Instagram. My name is Lindsay Deutsch, and I'm gonna flash that on your screen. See you soon.